Hello, and welcome to Dallas Delivers. I'm Linda Koop, and I'm proud to represent the people of Dallas and District 11. One issue that's very important to us in District 11 is the revitalization of older multifamily residences, as well as commercial areas. And here to discuss the future of our neighborhoods in transition is Chris Bueller, a member of the Plan Commission for the City of Dallas. Hi, Chris.
How do you do, Linda?
Welcome to Dallas Delivers.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to be here.
Well, we've had a lot of exciting things going on in District 11, which is in North Dallas. Can you tell us about some of the zoning cases that have come about?
Absolutely. It's my pleasure to talk about some of the exciting things that are happening in our part of town. I think one of the areas that's generating some of the most significant interest for revitalization and redevelopment is in the area around the Galleria. If you're familiar with the area, there's a mixture of low-density residential and commercial properties, many of which are aging. And there's been a tremendous interest among the development community to see those areas revitalized with much more mixed use and higher density products. I'm sure, very familiar with some of the recent activities that have occurred, large development happening at the old Duran Chevrolet site. That's projected to be something about a $1 billion project and involves many acres of that car retail site plus some of the surrounding properties to allow for a variety of residential, retail, and commercial uses with some very fascinating and unique architectural styles incorporated into that whole development. And so I think what's interesting about that development is it's generated a tremendous amount of interest among citizens and the development community to see what other kind of creative revitalization efforts can be conducted in that general part of town. And I think that long term, that project will take many, many years to develop and evolve, but it'll serve as a catalyst to see other redevelopment in the area occurring, say transitioning all the way over to the Spring Valley Coit area. So I think there's a genuine level of excitement, not only for the projects that are on the ground now that have recently been coming online, but some of these larger redevelopment efforts with these large, more intense mixed-use types of developments in that particular area. So it's an exciting part of town, and it will be for many, many years to come, I believe.
I think here in North Dallas, we are experiencing a renaissance, not only in the Galleria area and then parts north of there, and also the Valley View Mall area, but also down closer to Walnut Hill. Can you tell us a little bit about what went on at Walnut Hill and Central recently?
Yes. Well, unlike the Galleria, where we have a lot of residential and commercial areas that are redeveloping, the area near Walnut Hill and Central was an aging multifamily apartment complex. And the difference between that area and, say, the Galleria is it was much more adjacent to some established residential neighborhoods. So when that area was under the transition and plans were being drawn to revitalize that area, a lot of work went into working with surrounding neighborhoods to make sure that there's no frictional adjacency, meaning there's no encumbrances in terms of noise, height, and traffic that would be considered onerous to the surrounding properties in the established neighborhoods. So the city, the development community, and the neighbors alike are to be congratulated on the efforts that they went through to not only see the vision of revitalizing those aging apartments, but also accept some of this new and more intense mixed use. It's a combination of residential, retail, and commercial uses. And so that's an exciting area as well, again, because of its proximity not only to some established neighborhoods in the city, but also some institutions like Presbyterian Hospital, which is also nearby.
Well, that's exciting, too. You know, our district goes all the way from Arapahoe on the north all the way down to Walnut Hill. So LBJ Freeway sort of splits the district in half. So we have quite a wide range of geography to cover.
Yes.
Let's talk just a little bit about the Spring Valley Coit area over near Spring Valley and between Coit and Central Expressway. A neighborhood that has a lot of apartments that were built in the 70s and now looks like it's probably ripe for renovation. Any thoughts about that?
Again, I think that there's been some keen interest among the development community to see how that area can transition. Some of the attributes that make that area attractive for transitioning is that the existing developments are very low density, and with the increasing population and densities of our city, there's an interest in seeing those typically two or three story apartments redevelop into something that's a little bit taller that will support a variety of uses and not just low density residential. Also, the proximity to public infrastructure is important for large redevelopment efforts, and because the High Five is now completed that large public infrastructure investment is completed, that helps to open up that type of area, the Spring Valley Coit area, to see more intense uses and redevelopment occur.
Well, I think you're right there. It's got a great trail, as a matter of fact, and very close to the DART station there at Spring Valley and Central Expressway. So we look for great things to go in there, hopefully in the next few years, and the revitalization of that area and having more services and mixed use as well.
Yes.
So, well, we appreciate your efforts on behalf of District 11 being our plan commissioner. It's been great getting to know you and being able to work with you. And I want to encourage our citizens, if they have questions about how the plan commission works or land use in their area, to call my office and we'll get you in touch with them in short order. But we appreciate your efforts on the City of Dallas.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. And it's my pleasure to serve as a citizen volunteer to our fellow citizens in District 11 and the entire city.
Well, thanks, Chris. We appreciate you being here. And still to come on Dallas Deliver is how city leaders and members of law enforcement and the community are joining together to fight crime. And that's next here in City Channel 16, your 24/7 connection to Dallas City Government.